wanna feel myself. You want me to kill myself. Man, I've been on my own. Lord, I'ma need some help. I just wanna feel myself. You want me to kill myself. Man, I've been so damn long dealing with the things I feel. Suicidal thoughts, Scarlet, Krylon, Cobain. Two leather seats like a bloody stain.
It's Gabby and welcome back to my channel. So today's video is inspired by the new Denzel Curry music video for Clout Cobain. Clearly I was inspired by the makeup he had on. That entire video was really cool. I thought the aesthetic, the message, everything, how it was put together was amazing. And yeah, I just wanted to go ahead and recreate the look. So if you want to see how I put this together and the products I used, go ahead and keep watching. So to start things off, I am taking the Krylon face paint stick in the color white. I'm going to be applying that on my face in sections, then taking an old damp beauty blender to pounce around my face and blend out the paint. Now this paint isn't the creamiest, so you definitely have to put some work into it. You also don't want to overblend because you can start to pick the product back up, or you can start to see lines from where the beauty blender was on your face and it will create streaks. It's a very tedious process. You also want to be very careful because it can get messy too. As you can see, I got paint in my hair, so you want to make sure you're careful. This paint also isn't going to block out your eyebrows, so if you don't want them showing up, definitely do that beforehand. I wasn't super concerned about it, but I also couldn't be bothered to do it in the process. So yeah, if we're being honest. So once I've got the first layer down, I went in with a little extra paint to the areas that were still a little faint in color, so that way I could build up that base. Next, I took my Clinique spray in an attempt to help moisten up the paint to see if that would help with its blendability. I personally didn't notice much of a difference, so you can do that step at your own will. I also tried applying the paint directly to the sponge and firmly pressing that into my skin, and I did feel like that part helped like a little bit. Now I'm taking this black Makeup Forever liner pencil and I'm going to be lightly sketching out the outline for the big circle that is going to go around my left eye. This is why I wasn't super concerned with blocking out my eyebrows, because they were going to get covered with paint anyways, or covered in like the black liner. So once you're satisfied with your circle, we can move on to filling it in. So now I am taking this Inglot gel liner on a flat e.l.f. brush and using that to fill in the entire circle. Any smaller brush would work. This is just what I had laying around. So you can use black paint too, or anything else that you feel might help you fill in the circle. I just happen to have this liner pot on hand. So I'm just working in to make sure I get the liner to be really opaque and make sure that I keep inside the outline that I created. On a side note, if you're wondering what I am wearing, this is a Pennywise costume that I got last Halloween. I got mine at Hot Topic, but I'm not sure if it's still available on their website. But yeah, finally, I will fine tune any of the blending that still needs to happen. Also, I'm getting really close to my waterline, and then I'm gonna go back in with that Makeup Forever eyeliner pencil and make sure to get in there so that way there's no gaps in the black. Moving on to the other eye, I am taking my Anastasia Brow Wiz in the color Granite, and I'm roughly shaping out my eyebrow. Instead of trying to create a natural looking brow, I'm going to make sure this one is super blocky and thick. After I've established a shape, I am now going to take the Anastasia brow brush and I'm just going to dip that back into that Inglot liner and use that to really darken up the eyebrow. The goal is to make the eyebrow just as black as the other eye, so make sure that you don't leave any gaps. So once I've got that filled in for the most part, I'm just going to go in and do some minor touch-ups. If you make any mistakes with your eyebrow, or anything else for that matter, you can take a flat brush and coat that with the white paint, and then you can go back in and fix your work. This method works just the same as if you were carving your eyebrows out with some concealer. Moving along to eyeliner, I am taking my Fenty Beauty Flyliner and I'm working on winging out a heavy thick line on the top. Next, I'm going back in with my Make Up Forever pencil and I'm filling in my waterline and the lower lash line as well. Then I am focusing on connecting it to my wing and into the inner corner. I'm going to be taking that flat e.l.f. brush with the liner on it as well to make sure that everything is super dark and filled in. You also want to make sure that you're winging out the inner corner of your eye as well, just because that's another detail that was going on with his makeup. With my lips, once again, we are using that same black liner to outline my lips, and then taking the e.l.f. brush with more of the Inglot liner on it to fill in my lips. Obviously, if you have black lipstick, that would be much more ideal, but I surprisingly don't have any. So of course, eyeliner it is. I'm using that brush to do my best to clean up my lip line, and then we're done with that portion. After you've got your lips fully filled in, I'm taking the star of this show, it seems, that same black Make Up Forever liner, and again, I'm lightly sketching the lines on the sides of my face. Then I'm gonna go back in with a detail brush and really darken up those lines. Again, that's gonna be covered in that Inglot liner. I wish I could have gotten those lines cleaner, but this looks forgivable without it being an issue. If anything, the messier lines make it look creepier. Lastly, I am finishing things off with lashes. I've already applied a mascara and glued my lashes off camera. These are my tried and true Huda lashes in the style Scarlet. So once I finished adjusting my lashes, I can let my bangs free and fix and fluff my hair. And that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed. And yeah, you know, the more I make these videos, the more fun I have and the more I learn, you know, about filming myself, which has always been a challenge. But on top of that, you know, getting better in my own skills in makeup, because I'm not, you know, amazing, I'm not a professional, but I have a lot of fun. And although my lines may not be the cleanest and my application may not be the smoothest, I have a lot of fun and I hope you guys do too. So thank you so much for watching this video and I hope to see you in my next one. All right, so I get one shot at this. I don't even know if it's gonna do it because it might be dry or too dry, but let's see. So, I mean opposites, all right. I'm so nervous, okay. So, how does he do it in the video? Let me see. Like this, he wipes it down. Okay, I don't know if this is gonna work. All right, let's see. And 5, 4, 3, 2. I sort of did it. One more time. All right, bye.